Thank you again, Mr. Speaker. It was 50 years ago today that Robert F. Kennedy died from an assassin's bullet. He was just 42 years old. When we remember RFK's short but remarkable life, we recall the fierce U.S. Attorney General who fought against organized crime while serving in his brother JFK's cabinet. At the same time, we remember a man who emerged as a passionate advocate for social justice and civil rights during one of our nation's most turbulent times. While serving as U.S. Senator from New York in the years after his brother's assassination, Bobby Kennedy heard the call of Martin Luther King Jr., Cesar Chavez, and other civil rights leaders who urged peaceful change during turbulent times. As we struggled as a nation to find our public conscience in the midst of an identity crisis, RFK helped guide us by adding his voice to the fight and reminding us that without social justice and equality, the other victories were meaningless. Bobby once said, "Each time a man stands up for an ideal or acts to improve the lot of others or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring. Those ripples build a current that could sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance." On a personal note, my mother was 7 months pregnant with me when Bobby Kennedy was assassinated. I was named after Robert Kennedy, Robert Francis Matzie, 3 months after his assassination. So I have always felt that I had a kindred spirit in Bobby Kennedy, and now that public service is my life, I truly do. So I appreciate everybody's attention. I'll submit the remainder of my remarks for the record. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.